Heyo everybody, Haku here, finally continuing the Boku no Hero Academia read-through. Still have a sore throat, I'm still, well, I guess if you haven't watched the other videos, I've been sick for the past few days, so my throat hurts a bit, so I'm gonna have to drink a lot of water, especially reading four chapters of this. We should be doing 90, 91, 92, and 93? I believe those would be the four that we're on. And if there are any 0.5 Omega Omake, whatever's in there, I'll be doing those as well. So yeah, sorry I had to take last week off, it's just I had to get caught up with some other stuff. Also, other than that, yeah, I'm recording this Tuesday, so all the stuff I'm saying is gonna make sense for Tuesday, but when I post this Saturday, it's not gonna make a bunch of sense for Saturday, so that's really screwing with me right now. But if you ever want more Boku no Hero Academia, I do discuss things in the HaQ&A based on what you guys comment and stuff. And I think the one I just did on last week, it won't be the most recent one by the time you guys are seeing this, but I think there was like 10 minutes of Boku no Hero Academia discussion there. And I mean, that's pretty good. That's at least 10 minutes of extra discussion a week if I cover that much or get that many comments to discuss. But either way, let's get into reading this. We left off with All For One had just bailed out the Villain Alliance, and All Might had just come in for the save against him. So those two were squaring off now. Lots of badass stuff happened, like with the Nomus coming out of the just coming out of thin air. That scene was probably my favorite from last time, when the Nomus just started coming out of thin air. That was so cool. Also, I was told that before I read this week's, before I continued reading, I needed to go back and remember Shigaraki's real name, and because it was apparently said, and I went back and looked, and it is Tenko, I believe. So I will keep that in mind as we continue reading, because I'm not sure when that will be important. Just checking my audio one more time before I get into it, and it looks like we're all good. So, starting with Chapter 90, Taking His Hand. Okay, let's just get through all these translator note pages. Okay, come now, that was far too slow for you. A tumultuous clash. Not starting this off in the pronunciation game. Whoa, and we see all the students and Villain Alliance guys all flying back. Even All Might. This place is only a little over 5 kilometers from the bar. For it to have taken you 30 whole seconds to arrive from when I sent you all those Nomus, how weak you've become, All Might. Right back at you, you son of a bitch. Wanna fill me in on that mask? When did your neck sprout an industrial zone? You're certain you're not overexerting yourself. Man, the first time I've really heard All Might ever talk trash to somebody. The fucker repelled All Might with his bare hands? He must be the villain's boss, thinks Katsuki. I won't make the same mistake I made 5 years ago. All For One. I'm going to take back Bakugo, my boy. And then, this time, I'm going to make sure to throw you into the slammer, right alongside the Villain Alliance you control. Is that so? Then it'd seem you have a dreadful number of things to do. As do I. And his arm starts to either twist or expand, and he just sends a wave of air forward. His powers are presumably innumerous, so he sends All Might flying, so this is pretty much complete, utter strength, just insane strength versus every power ever. Like Superman versus Superman. Man. Air propulsion plus musculoskeletal coiling, 4 instantaneous impact quirks, 3 physical strength amplification quirks. This combination is a fun one. Perhaps I shall pile on a few more amplifier quirks. So, that I like. Like, he's collecting physical strength quirks and then piling them on top of each other? That's very interesting. All Might, yells, I believe that's Katsuki. Don't worry, he won't die from a love tap like that. And as such, escape from this place, Tamura, and take the boy with you. Very interesting. It looks like his hand may be robotic. Or maybe that's just another one of the quirks. Huh. It looks like his hands are maybe just going apart into threads of some kind. It's very interesting. Black Mist, usher everyone back, he says, stabbing the weird finger things into him. Hello? The guy's clearly knocked out. Like, I don't know what's going on, but if you can use warps or whatever, then would you warp us back yourself? Says Magne. I'm afraid my warp quirk is still quite fresh, Magne, my dear. Not only is its range of transport exceedingly limited, it differs from his coordinate-based warp quirk that I can only bring matter to me or send it away from me. For that matter, the destination must be a person I know intimately or it won't work. Interesting that he has the specifics for us. Also, me and my friend were talking about it as well this week, where I was saying to me, Black Mist quirk is like probably the most OP. Like, that he can send anyone anywhere at any time just from coordinates. Like, he doesn't have to see the place. It doesn't have to be within a certain range, it would seem, because he has transported people across, like, cities worth of distance before. So, he has crazy, crazy, like, his quirk to me is the most OP. There are some other OP ones, like number 13s. If he wanted to, he could be a complete beast. But either way, forced quirk activation. Now go. But Sensei, you... And then we see All Might charging back. You're not getting away. Tomura, always keep in mind that you've still got so much room to grow. And then he blocks another shot from All Might. Come on, Shigaraki, let's hightail it while Piped's keeping All Might busy, says, I believe that's Mr. Compress, and he compresses Dobby. Grab the pawn. Goddamn, pain in the ass, says, Katsuki. Yo, so is Izuku's group going to fight these guys off of Katsuki while All Might fights All for One? That would be pretty cool. Bakugo, my boy. All Might, says Izuku, and we see Izuku and Todoroki behind one of the fallen walls. He can't rescue Kachan. He's got his hands full beating back All for One. Meanwhile, the Alliance is capitalizing on that opening to try to flee with Kachan in tow. And Kachan's caged in on all sides with nowhere to run. And we see a really cool panel of Katsuki dealing with Twice, Himiko, and Mr. Compress all at the same time. Man, and he's using his explosions to just sort of bounce them away. I'm trying to look. Twice's weapon is very odd. Oh yeah, he uses ropes, right? There are ropes in those collars. I was gonna say it looks almost like a ruler or something the way it's drawn. Very interesting. It's not just me, these fuck rags are also running in emergency mode, thinks Katsuki. Unlike a minute ago, now they're trying to take me by force if necessary. It's 6-on-1. But whatever, for the time being, I just can't let myself get touched by the motherfucker with the mask. And he sends an explosion at Mr. Compress. I'm coming, says All Might. So 1v6 will, with the help of Izuku's team, turn into 6v6. I won't let you, says I'm really interested at what that quirk is that he's using. All for One pinning All Might to the ground with those weird finger things. In fact, that's why I'm here. And he tosses him backwards. It doesn't get much more dire than this, but even so, we aren't allowed to fight. And he's thinking back to what everyone told him about not fighting. Okay. Please give me an opening, anything, somewhere. I don't care if it's only a split second. Is there really no way to save him? If only Kachan were saved, then All Might could unleash his power, full power, freely. All Might. I think in an emergency situation, the whole ability to fight should just be anybody can have the ability to fight if somebody is going to die or be kidnapped if you don't. That's like saying if they saw a murder in progress, they would have to sit there and watch because they couldn't fight. It's like, no, that would be a shitty, shitty law. We need an opening. Ida, guys... No, you can't, Midoriya, says Ida. Yes, we can, because we won't be engaging in battle. We ought to be able to get away and rescue Kachan at the same time. There is a way. Go on, says Todoroki. Although, it also depends on what Kachan will do. Stay away, Deku. Bakugo would most likely see getting saved by everyone as a disgrace. This plan probably won't work. If I do it. You do it, Kirishima. You're the key to raising our chances of success. Right now, Kachan is being wary of his opponents, and fighting them at a distance. The perfect timing is when Kachan is more than 2 paces away from all the villains. Ida. It's a gamble, but if you think about it, the risk to us is low, and if we do succeed, the tables will turn very much in our favor, says Ida. Let's do it. Yo, Ida, you guys have known since the beginning Ida's been one of my favorite characters, though. First, we build forward momentum through my full cowl and Ida's reciproco. Then, Kirishima will use hardening to break through the wall. The second we open the way, I want you to freeze us a path, Todoroki. And we see them charging through with the recipro and full cowl, with Kirishima punching through the wall. Make it so we fly as high as possible. Yo, and we see Twice sees them and gets distracted. Then Shigaraki looks over. The villains haven't noticed us. Up until now, we kept getting the ground swept from under our feet by them, but now we have a chance to return the favor. So we'll rocket across the battlefield at a height they can't reach us. And we see Himiko and Twice looking up towards them. The villain's boss may be holding All Might at bay, but if you flip your thinking, then the reverse is true too. Plus, it's gotta be you, Kirishima. It can't be me. It can't be Todoroki Arita or Yayorozu either. Ever since we entered Yue, you've built a relationship with him as equals. Yo, and like I said, I always love the relationship between those two. If the one who calls out to him is a friend, then take my hand, and Kirishima's reaching down for him, and we see All Might get off a shot to the face of All For One. Then Shigaraki's diving in, trying to reach for Katsuki. Katsuki explodes upwards and grabs his hand. You idiot. He took it. Number 90, end. That was a good one. I really like the plan that Izuku made up there. I really like that. And now we have a full jump cover for the next chapter. But either way, I really like that one. Between chapters, I'm going to grab water, though, just to make sure my throat stays okay. Oh my gosh, I really, really like that one. I like that one a lot. I like when in shonen, I guess, just in general, when you see a good plan or strategy. So I really like that. I really like fights that involve a complex strategy as well. But that was good. Okay. I like this Izuku jump cover we got here. Oh, how quirkily they dance. And we see some of the characters. Hello, Ashido. Okay. Mashirao hanging onto the pole with his tail. Oh my gosh. Okay, just getting a good look at that. Alright, now we're at number 91, the symbol of peace. After watching All Might. All Might is only having a rough time fighting because I'm here. With my reciprocal, and that's what Akatsuki was thinking, now we see what Ida's thinking. With my reciprocal, we can escape. And then there's no doubt that All Might heal. And then we see Izuku thinking, Kachan will definitely understand. My body's atrophy strangely subsided. What's the best move we can make? And then they start flying out of there. What the, says Spinner. Bakugo, on my signal, propel us with your explosion, says Ida. No, you do shit on my signal. Is this any time to compete? It's just as I thought, they're rooted to the ground, thinks Todoroki. This is our chance to run. Okay. Now then. They're everywhere, crawling out of the woodworks, says Shigaraki. Holy hell, I can't believe it, says All Might. Don't let them get away. Everybody here, got anything long range, says Mr. Compress. Dobby and Black Mist are both down, says Spinner. Get together, you two. Magne, quirk magnetism. He can magnetize any person within a 4.5 meter radius. Interesting. I thought he could only just control magnetic substances. This is interesting, though. It can be adjusted to magnetize the whole or just part of the target. Men become S-polarized, and women become N-polarized, or South or North polarized. He can't magnetize himself, though. Okay, interesting. Ready, boys? Repulsion force breakup. Fly-by-night cannon. Hmm? Oh, because they were both south, they repelled from each other. So it sent, So as long as he held spinner to keep him from flying backwards, it sent compress forward. And then... he runs straight into, the growing giant version of, Mount Lady. Titan Cliff. Mount Lady. His rescue comes first, she says, smiling. So go, you little brats. And she starts falling over. Mount Lady, best girl, for the win. We can still catch them, just one more shot, says, Magne, pulling over twice. And then bam, both of them get, struck. And Izuku looks back. Ah, it's Gran Torino. Took you long enough, says, All Might. You're the one who's too damn fast. Must be Shimura's friend, says, says, All For One. I always forget his name, I do not even know why. Listen here, that Midoriya is really getting more and more like you. Going down a bad direction. I never thought he'd come after his experience in Hosu, teens. But, pitiful as it may be now, says All Might, now I'm totally free. I think it's good. I think a hero should be going to save as many people as they can. And we see, Izuku, Katsuki, Eijiro, and, Ida getting away. Now, I can defeat you. I got two more villains to mop up over here, says Torino, running in towards, Shigaraki and, Himiko. I don't want this to end, Tomura. Foiled by a single move, says, All For One. The tables have turned, and then his attack goes straight past All Might and into a Magne. Forced quirk activation, magnetism. So he also has a quirk that forces quirks to activate. He can take quirks, apparently give quirks, but we haven't really seen that I know of. Like, directly. I mean, with the no moves, we kind of sort of seen it, but we haven't really seen the process that it takes. But either way. I'll turn you to dust, says Shigaraki, as Gran Torino flies towards him, and then he misses his kick because the Magne quirk sends Shigaraki flying backwards towards Himiko, because that would make her north polarized and him south. Oh, and it would make the rest of them south as well. No, this is all so sudden, you... Man, Himiko is, I don't want to say she's best girl, but she's certainly up there. And they're all men, so they all go flying towards her. And it knocks them all back through the, portal. Wait, Sensei, you can't, says, Shigaraki as he's flying backwards. And then he throws, Magne into the portal. And knocks, Gran Torino away. With that body, you'll know. And we see back to him reaching out to little kid Shigaraki again. I'm still, and he takes the hand off his face. Tomura, you must carry on the fight, he says. Ah, so is All For One planning to sacrifice himself here? Oh no, he's just going to warp, because he said he can warp to or away from his body, if he knows the person. Transport. Impact inversion. I'd only come to aid Tomura, but... if you insist on fighting, then I accept your challenge. And he sends Gran Torino straight into All Might's punch. It would appear. I'm sorry, he says. I do despise you after all, says All For One. You crushed all of my comrades with those fists one by one, and the world sang your praises as the symbol of peace. The vista you view standing atop the mound of our dead must be nice, surely. Detroit Smash. And then he goes in for a punch that All for One blocks. And we see the wind flying all around him. He canceled out through sheer force. I won't let you fight as freely as you'd like. Heroes always have so many things that need protecting. And we see the wind blowing all around a bunch of civilians in the background that heroes are trying to get out of the way, it looks like. Shut up. That's how you always toy with others. You destroy them and rob them. You use them and dominate them. This is bad. I need to transport. All the while sneering down from your wanton perch at those who live their day-to-day lives. I will never, ever allow such evil. And he cracks his face into the ground, straight through the mask. Toshinori, it's my limit. And he starts reverting back into his weakened self. How awfully sentimental, All Might. Truth be told, I've heard more or less the same lines before. Has his full-strength swing missed its mark? From the mouth of a prior wielder of One for All, Shimura Nana. Yo, what in the heck is this lump of flesh? Is there nothing there? Because it looks like a lump of flesh. And is this a weird robotic body like I was asking before? So many questions this is bringing up. But that's it for 92, so we're about to move into... Oh no, that's it for 91, we're about to move into 92. Okay, got confused at where we had started. I thought we'd started on 91. This has been really good so far. I really like that chapter as well. Just because I like seeing the different uses of all the quirks and seeing Magne trying to send people flying, or then All for One using Magne's quirk to his advantage, all of that was good. And it's interesting how he can not take their quirks, but force them to activate and sort of use them how he would like. Very interesting. Alright, now the first page of this one we have Todoroki with a cell phone. Midoriya, you guys alright? Yeah, what about you guys? Did you get away? They zoomed a hole through enemy lines, Katsuki safely in hand. Looks like it. All the pros who ran in the opposite direction from that villain are guiding people to refuge. Thank God. Okay. Yeah, and we see Yaoyorozu and Todoroki are with the refugees that are getting led away. We're by the station. That shockwave must not have reached up here. The rescue's a success. I didn't get rescued, got it? You chuckleheads were just the best escape route out of there. Can't argue with that, says Eijiro. I just didn't want to be in All Might's way. And I really like that, though, how Katsuki was planning to get away all along just because he knew that fighting would be bad for All Might. Very smart. Yeah, we'd only be getting in his way. Given what we can do right now, this is the best we can hope for. And besides, he even has Gran Torino with him. Newscopters, are they broadcasting this? With this, we've done all we could, right? It'll be all right, right, All Might? From the mouth of a prior wielder of One for All, Shimura Nana. I don't want to hear Master's name coming from your filthy goddamn mouth. Be proud, Toshinori. You're fundamentally different from someone who's had it from the start. No, you had to earn your power, my friend. He's thinking back to her telling him the same thing he told Izuku. And his face is kind of like a lump of flesh. She was a wretch of a woman, who concerned herself solely of her ideals, devoid of any and all talent. As the progenitor who birthed One for All, I feel ashamed. The way she met her end was truly, truly pathetic. Where should I even begin? Enough. He says, throwing him, and he gets thrown into the sky. Damn! And now he doesn't really have his full power to really, save him much anymore. Yeah, and he's lucky at least the newscopters are on his good side. Toshinori, says, Gran Torino grabbing him. And, we see, All for One wheezing. Damn it. You're just repeating what happened 6 years ago. Calm down, you let him provoke you like that back then, too. And that's how you ended up failing to capture him. That's how you got that hole in your stomach. That's always been your problem. Quit trading words with the bastard. Yes, sir. Both his battle tactics and the quirks he's using are totally different compared to last time. We can't land any effective blows at close quarters. We've got no choice but to get him when his guard's down. You can still move, right? Now's the time to surpass your limits. This is do or die. Right, sir. Man, and All Might's gonna keep pushing and fighting. It's a nightmarish scene. In no time at all, Kamino Ward has been leveled half to dust. At the moment, it appears All Might is locked in battle with the villain thought to be the mastermind. I can't believe it. A single villain destroyed the city. A single villain is proving more than a match for All Might's power. And we see, Aizawa, Nedzu, and Vlad are watching the news. The city's been crushed. Tsukauchi, All Might, thinks Nedzu. Then, the hell's going on? Looks really bad. Is that Uraraka? I can't even tell. The hell's going on? Or maybe it's just random people watching. No, that's not Uraraka, because now we see her in the next page. Ain't All Might looking pretty damn beat up? I mean, wow. Where's Kamino again? Yeesh, look at him, he's trashed. Papa might get off from work tomorrow. Wah, what the hell are all the other heroes doing? And we see it's what all the different people across the city are saying. Damn hero slacking off. Nah, just kidding. Although, shit man, the villains have been getting a little too buck wild lately. Or rather, I get the feeling heroes are getting their asses handed to them a lot. But come on, at the end of the day, this is All Might we're talking about. He'll pull it off somehow. And we see Aoyama, Tokuyami, Uraraka, Mineta, and Asui all watching the TV. Tomura toiled so tirelessly to erode the public's faith in heroes, but perhaps it's acceptable for I to deal the final blow, he says. But you do realize, All Might, that just as you hate me, I too hate you. Certainly, I killed your master, but you robbed me of all that I worked to amass. That's why I want you to die the most savage, ugly death possible. And then he starts, using that move with his arm again. Here comes that big punch. Dodge it and rush into counter. Are you sure you want to dodge it? He says. And All Might hears rustling behind him in the rubble. Watch out, says Torino coming in. I shall snatch away all the things you've been protecting. Starting with the pride you took in soldiering on despite your injuries. Show the world how pitiful you really look. O symbol of peace. And in order to protect the rubble, he took the shot directly and lost all of his power. Man, All Might is not looking good. And I'm wondering, did they get all of the other injured heroes out of there? Like, what happened to Mount Lady and all the other injured ones? Or are they just on the other side or something? Huh? Whoa, who's that skeleton? Wait, what the? My eyes aren't deceiving me, are they, viewers? All Might seems emaciated. I haven't told the public about my condition, so I ask you to respect my wishes and keep mum. But that's, says Izuku, the symbol of peace who always rescues innocence with a smile, must never succumb to the forces of evil. Still secret, says Izuku. Your hollow cheeks, your eyes sunken. What a scrawny top hero you've become. But don't be embarrassed. That's your true form, isn't it? Says All For One. That how you see it? Well, however much my body may be withering away, and however much that's been exposed for all to see, my heart is still the heart of the symbol of peace. And that heart isn't something you could ever take the smallest piece away from. And then he says, magnificent, how could I forget that childish obstinacy of yours? I wonder if your heart will remain unscathed after you hear this. You see, Shigaraki Tomura is Shimura Nana's grandson. This entire time, I've been devising that which would upset you. Interesting. I orchestrated an opportunity for you and Tomura to face off, and you smacked him down, beaming with the pride of victory and so blissfully unaware. You lie, says All Might. Oh, but it is the truth. Surely you don't doubt that it's something I would do you? What's this? All Might? How odd. Whatever happened to that smile? Listen up. Saving people means first and foremost fearing for their safety. And a true hero saves not only people's lives, but also their hearts. That's what I want to believe. He thinks back to Nana. And no matter how afraid you are, you've just gotta slap a big ol' smile on. You just gotta slap on a big ol' smile and say, it'll be all right. Because it's always the guys who smile who are the strongest guys out there. You bastard. Just as I thought, how delightful. I did manage to rob you of a precious little piece of your heart. He's a relative of Master's. Him? Ah, what have I done? So this makes the hand on his face that he calls father, or that calls him father, or I think he calls father, very, very interesting and very weird. But either way. And we see, the person in the rubble behind him. Don't give up. All Might, please. Save me. Man. All Might. Whoa. He can't really be that. What? Says Katsuki. No, I can't bear seeing him like this. All Might, and it's all the people across the country, the world may be watching. If you can't beat him, then who the hell can? Forget how he looks. He's still All Might, isn't he? He always comes and saves the day somehow. Come on, All Might, you can do it. Don't give in, All Might. Come on, fight. And everybody's cheering for him. Win the day, All Might. And we see Katsuki and Izuku crying. Man, this is getting emotional for me. Have no fear, young lady. You were right, all for one. Heroes always have so many things, so many people to protect. That's the very reason they can't lose, and his arm gets all pumped up again. For the sakes of those who call his name, he'll rise back up on your feet no matter how many times it takes. Man, that was probably the best chapter in the manga so far, in my opinion. That is the strongest and most emotional one. Let me get some water. Holy shit. That was damned impressive. Okay, so now we have chapter 93, The Embers of One for All. And it looks like we're starting with some sort of flashback. His master's voice echoes from the flame within him. Remember, whenever you feel like you're past your limit, must remember. For what purpose do you curl those fists? Why am I? Just think back to your origin, man. That's what'll always take you just a little bit farther than your so-called limit. I want to make the world a place where everyone can smile and live in peace. And to that end, they need a symbol. And we see young All Might. The hero yet lives. You can still move, right? Now's the time to surpass your limits. And we see Gran Torino looking on. I couldn't even count how many massive scale attacks he's cancelled out. He must have passed his limit a while ago. That warped right arm only muscle form says it all. Use all your might. After all, that will be your last swing, All Might. Wounded heroes are always the most fearsome ones. In my dreams, I still sometimes see you coming towards me, your face dead set despite your strewn bowels. I suppose I should watch out for swings 2 and 3 then? And then we see flames coming in at him from behind, and he just swipes them all away. What the hell, you bastard, says Endeavor. The hell's that body, All Might? And we see Ed Shot is with him as well. Then we see Tsukauchi capturing all the Nomus. Though they were all mid-range Nomus, don't tell me you brought them all to heal already. I must applaud you, Number Two. You're certainly a man who's clawed his way to the top. I studied and trained so hard and in so many ways to surpass you. And the more I did, the more deeply I felt it. All Might, the gap between us. The sight of you with your back toward me. The despair of it drove me to... And then he thinks about Todoroki and his wife. How did your back get so pitiful? And he erupts into flames. If you only came here to cheer him on, then make like proper spectators and be quiet. And then we see Ed Shot go past him. Speak, O Destroyer, for we have come to aid him. And then we see Kamui Wood rushes in and grabs the fallen heroes. Okay? You did good, Mount Lady. And we see the person behind Toshinori is getting rescued by Tora. Yo, so Tora is a badass. I love Tora. For us, this is about all we can do. But if it alleviates your burden by just a tiny bit, and then All Might looks back, Tora, so go. Stop that wicked lot, All Might. Everyone's hoping you win. And we see Eddshot and Endeavor still trying to hold off One for All. No matter how you may look, you are the number one hero. And then we see a flashback. Yagi Toshinori, he's got some crazy ideas, it's great. He says that the reason crime rates won't drop is because people haven't got a place to put their faith in. This country lacks a pillar, he says. And then he goes, that's why I'll become that pillar. And it's Nana talking to a younger Gran Torino. Everybody is hoping, praying, that you win. And we see the flashes to all of the characters. How annoying, says All For One, pushing the pushing air away from himself and knocking everyone away. Let us put aside any talk of your spirit and talk reality. Musculoskeletal qualification, plus 4 instantaneous impact quirks, plus 3 physical strength amplification quirks, plus proliferous growth, plus hypertrophy, plus rivets, plus airwalk, plus bone spears. It seems there's no guarantee I'll kill you just shaving off your power with the shockwaves I've been using up until now. So, in order to assuredly kill you, I shall hybridize all of the best and most suitable quirks I can at the moment, and strike you with them. What in the hell? Like, that is an insane power. Also, Bone Spear sounds like a pretty badass quirk, just on its own. Just now, I was finally able to confirm it, All Might. One for All is no longer within you. What you've been using is nothing more than a lingering echo, the dregs of the power, embers left from after you transferred it. And that fire grows weaker every time you use it. Now that feeble little light will fade without even needing to blow it out. Man. Midoriya Izuku, he says. That's the name of the man you transferred One for All to, correct? And to think, he came with no qualifications. He hasn't even mastered it yet, has he? I hope you die nursing plenty of regrets, All Might. Today, you lose not only as a hero, but as a teacher as well. And they both go in for their final blow. And the city friggin' erupts. Impact reversal. All of that force you unleashed will reflect back. That's right, All Might says. As a teacher, I must be there to scold him. I need to be the one to scold him. I see. How unseemingly, says One for All, or All for One. That feeble little ember that will fade out without even needing to blow it out. Are you resisting its disappearance, denying it? Are you really fighting against it so desperately, just so it won't snuff out before you complete your duty? Remember, whenever you feel you're past your limit, it's not just as a symbol. I need to follow in Master's footsteps, just as she taught me. And until I raise him properly, I too. I can't say that I foresaw you resisting that desperately, debasing yourself that much. Cannot allow myself to die. And he goes in with the other arm and punches him. A fist that believes in the future. The fist that bridges the next generation. Man, sucks that we have to... Huh? That was weird. Okay, it's a raw page they had. Man, sucks that we have got to end this here. Man. Oh well, though. Next week we'll have 94, 95, 96, and 97. And, really... A week ain't that long. So, yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. I really enjoyed reading it. Chapter 93 was great as well, but Chapter 92, that was, like, my favorite of this whole series so far, possibly. But, either way, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Like, if you did like the video, comment down there. Tell me what you thought of this week's 4 chapters, what you thought of my thoughts on them. Subscribe for more Boku no Hero Academia and a bunch more. I'm going to be watching the first season of the anime soon so that I can cover the second season on the channel week to week. So that'll be pretty interesting. Did I already say subscribe? Yeah, subscribe if you want to for everything, whatever. Well, on Twitter if you want. I'll try to keep you updated there and stuff for the channel. That's it. So thank you once again for watching, and I'll see you all next time.